happy Sabbath to everyone who has tuned into this ministry at the Magazine Street Seventh-day Adventist Church here in Louisville, Kentucky. I am the senior pastor of this fine congregation. My name is Dr. George E. Thornton, Sr., and we are so glad that you were able to tune in today for this another dynamic word from the Word of God through His manservant. Last week, we spoke to you on the subject entitled, In the Room Where It All Happened. And we talked about John Bolton's book, his revelation about Donald Trump, what took place in the Oval Office, the room where it all happened. But we shifted from John Bolton and we went to another room where it all happened. And it was on the day of Pentecost when the disciples were gathered together in the upper room and the Holy Ghost fell upon them. And they were cloven with fire and tongues in their fire in their tongues, and they were able to speak languages that they had not spoken before because the Holy Ghost had fell upon them. And it all happened in the upper room where it all happened. So today we come with another exciting word. I want to call your attention to a passage of scripture in the book of Genesis, chapter 3, the book of Genesis, chapter 3, and I want to read in your hearing verses 7 through 13 and verse 21. The book of Genesis, in the beginning, the book of Genesis, chapter 3, and verses 7 through 13 and verse 21. Whatever device you have and whatever Bible translation you have, we invite you to read along with us in your home, in your living room, in your kitchen, in your dining room, in your bedroom, wherever you are, as you listen to this ministry, this broadcast today. We invite you to open up the Word of God. Genesis chapter 3, beginning with verse 7, and the eyes of them both were open, and they knew that they were naked, and they sewed fig leaves together and made themselves aprons. And they heard the voice of the Lord walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden. And the Lord called unto Adam and said unto him, Where art thou? And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself. And verse 11 says, and the Lord said, Who told thee that you were naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree where I have commanded thee that thou should not eat? And the man said, The woman whom thou gavest to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the woman, What is it that thou hast done? And the woman said, The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And move over to verse 21. Verse 21 says, Unto Adam also and to his wife did the Lord God make coats of skins and clothe them. I want to preach on the subject entitled, listen carefully now, For Sale by Owners, not owner, but owners, plural, masks and fig leaves. For sale by owners, masks and fig leaves. Let's bow our heads in prayer and ask God to use us as we deliver this word today, that someone may be blessed today, wherever you might be listening into this ministry. Father God, we thank you today that you blessed us to see another Sabbath, to come into worship, even though we are not in the physical structure in terms of people gathered together. Your word still can go forth where people can be blessed. Use this preacher today to present your word. Hide me behind the cross that Christ may be seen and uplifted. And oh God, I will be careful as best I know how to give you all of the praise, the honor, and the glory, because you're God all by yourself. For we ask it all in the worthy name of Jesus. Bind the devil so that nothing would prohibit this word going out, that somebody might be blessed today. For we ask it all in the worthy name of Jesus, and for his sake, Oh, let everybody say amen. Even though I can't hear you, you still can say amen. Amen and amen. For sale by owners, masks and fig leaves. When you think about all that we're dealing with now, mask wearing is as old as creation. In fact, when our first parents, Adam and Eve, tried to manufacture fig leaves to cover themselves from their nakedness, mask wearing and this idea of fig leaves started all the way back in the garden. Now, do not let my title mislead you or misguide you. I know there's an ongoing and much debate about whether a person should or should not wear masks during this COVID-19 pandemic. I know that, and I'm not here to argue that. But according to the CDC, it strongly recommends that or advise people to wear cloth face covering in public setting when they are around other people who do not live in their household. Mask covering, they say, may help prevent people who have COVID-19 from spreading the virus to other people. And I think that's a good thing. And yet, on the other hand, there are those who refuse to wear masks. In fact, just yesterday, July the 10th, the governor of the state of Kentucky has now made it mandatory that everyone has to wear a mask when they're out in public or going to places where people gather. It is mandatory now that they have to wear a mask or a covering over their face. And yet there are those who, no matter what the governor might say, no matter what the edict, no matter what the mandate might be, there are those who still feel as though they don't have to wear a mask in public setting. And then there are those who on the other hand, they find it tough or hard to wear a mask because people are fighting to take the mask off in order that they may be able to breathe. And so some people say, I can't wear this thing because I cannot breathe. And so the debate goes on and on and on as to whether or not one should or one should not wear a mask. People, however, the purpose of my message today is not to advise or to argue against whether you should or should not wear a mask. That's not my position here today. I'll leave that to the scientists, and I'll leave that to the medical experts and to your own conscience. But the focal point of my message of sermon today is to draw some parallels that God has dropped on me and spiritual insight between mask wearing today and the wearing of fig leaves by our first parents produced by Adam and Eve back in the garden. Come on, say amen, somebody. In the beginning of creation, Adam and Eve were without disguise or covering. They wore no mask. Those famous fig leaf aprons were only part of their cover-up. And this came from the prolific writer. She says that this came from their cover-up, distortion, hatred, jealousy, control, and many other vices all causing us to wear a mask. And guess where I found that little nugget from? That came out of Adventist home. Wow. See, before the fall, Adam and Eve were clothed with covering of the light and glory such as the angels wear. This is found in Patriarchs and Prophets, page 45. The garment of innocence covered Adam and Eve. And as long as they were obedient to God, they were covered in this Shekinah glory of the innocence of God around them. But when they transgressed the command of God and the forbidden fruit, ate the forbidden fruit, the covering of light was immediately lost. Notice our text this morning says, in Genesis chapter 3 and verse 7, then the eyes of both of them were open, and they knew that they were naked. It has always been interesting, as I've looked at this account in Genesis chapter 3, about our first parents, Adam and Eve, it has always been interesting to me that the covering of light did not disappear and leave Eve naked after she had partaken of the forbidden fruit. It was not until Adam ate that their eyes were opened and they both knew that they were naked. And then I also discovered what was also interesting, that their supernatural covering could not get dirty. It could not get dirty. They did not require cleaning. It was always the correct size. No matter how tall Adam and Eve grew, that covering grew with them. Somebody ought to say amen. It was always a perfect in their appearance and could not grow old or wear out. Wow. As long as they had that supernatural covering on them, it could never grow old or wear out, and it always grew with them. But notice, because of their disobedience, they lost that innocent, that supernatural covering. They got what they wanted, but lost what they had. Oh my God, I'm preaching to somebody. They got what they wanted, but they lost what they had. Let me drop this on you. Let me drop this on you. They say wearing a mask during the pandemic virus, you are protecting yourself from others. But notice, when Adam and Eve in Genesis chapter 3, when they wear the fig leaves or use the fig leaves to protect themselves, they were hiding themselves from the Almighty God. Hiding behind a mask and a fig leaf is nothing new, brothers and sisters. Both garments are uncomfortable wardrobes. I do not care how much you try to dress up your mask or your fig leaves. They're still uncomfortable garments. I want you to notice something about the mask and the fig leaf analogy that this preacher wanted to put on you today. Note, both the mask and the fig leaf analogy, both were worn during the pandemic. We wear masks because of the COVID-19 pandemic. Adam and Eve wore the fig leaf because of the pandemic of the virus of sin had now entered into the world. Both were worn for protection. Mask is used for protection. The fig leaves were used to protect Adam and Eve. From who? From God Almighty. Both were worn for a period of time. That's why I've entitled the message "For Sale by Owners: Masks and Fig Leaves." We're not made to wear masks and fig leaves forever. At some point, we've got to stop faking it, drop the mask, and take off the fig leaves. If we're going to be truthful and honest about it with ourselves, the disguise and the masquerade has got to go. The sham, the pretense, the put on, they only can last but for so long. The Bible says, "Ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free." Let me keep it real. I've discovered it in this whole process that we hide behind much stuff, and we are not fooling anyone nor no one but ourselves when we wear masks and fig leaves to try to cover up something that we are hiding. But in reality, we are only fooling ourselves when we think about it. We wear masks to give a false impression or presence about where we live, who we're married to, what we drive, and how wonderful our children are, or how much we love our church. That's all masks and fig leaf stuff. I submit to you that the church of the living God is the biggest manufacturer of fig leaf garments. Because the church has taught us, I know you don't want to hear this today, but the church has taught us how to pretend, how to give a false impression rather than being open, being honest, being real. The church doesn't allow us to be honest and be open with each other. So we come in every week after week with this fake mask, with this fake fig leaf on, trying to let people know that we are such and such and we are so and so. But in reality, we are fooling no one but ourselves. And every Sabbath, we put on that fig leaf dress, that fig leaf suit, and we go around pontificating. And we say, happy Sabbath. But in reality, there's no happiness in the house of God. Oh, somebody ought to say amen. And yet every week, week after week, we go to the fig leaf departmental store. And we buy those things to try to impress people, to try to let people believe, have people to believe that we're all that in a bag of chips. Fig leaf mentality. And we do it week after week. We put up this pretense. We put up this false idea about who we really are. Look at Adam and Eve's situation. Before they sinned, they lived a completely honest and openness and freedom before each other and before God. That's how the Lord planned it, that they could be open and honest with each other and with God himself. But notice, when sin entered, when they became disobedient, they tried to cover up stuff. Matthew chapter 10 and verse 26 says this to us, fear them not, therefore shall not be revealed, and all that's covered will be opened. So there's nothing that we can do or say that we're going to hide from God, because everything that is covered will be open and everything that is closed will be revealed. Matthew 10:26 tells us. And yet we go week after week, day after day, to hide behind these fig leaves. And I don't know about you, but I'm thankful for COVID-19 pandemic, because it really has stripped the church of all of these fig leaves, because now the church has to be authentic, it has to be real, it has to be open, it has to face the community. Because before the pandemic, we were in here having a masquerade party, fooling ourselves with each other. And while the whole community is going to hell, we're in here masquerading, pretending like we got it all together. In fact, we tell people, or people have the notion or believe, that they can't come into the church until they get right, because we give them this impression that somehow, because we attend church, we go to church, we keep the Sabbath, somehow that we've got it all together. But baby, all we have on is nothing but fig leaves. Somebody ought to say amen. Notice, all throughout Genesis chapter 3, the theme is now, and they knew that they were naked. They know they are naked. Notice a question the Lord posed to Adam specifically. He said, who told you, in verse 11, who told you that you were naked? It suggests that Adam and Eve never thought of their nakedness. It was a natural way to be, and they did not give it any thought. But now they were filled with shame that was brought on because of their disobedience. And now they tried to find something to cover themselves from the presence of God. Shame and guilt makes us cover up stuff. Come on and say amen. And it teaches us how to pretend, how to hide. We learn it early, even as little children. When we do wrong, or when we do something that we know is not right, we know how to cover it up. We know how to give a pretense. Now, to cover up their shame and guilt and disobedience, they chose fig leaves for their covering. Now watch this. They ate the fruit that caused their disobedience. Now they choose a fruit tree to help them out. Help me, somebody. They ate the fruit, the forbidden fruit, that caused their disobedience. Now they go to a fig tree, a fruit tree, to help them out. What do you mean, brother preacher? Sometimes we use the same tools or the same tactics that got us into trouble in the first place. And we keep going around and around and around until we come clean with the fact that we have sinned and come short of the glory of God. See, this fruit fig leaf tree was easily attainable to them, yet it was insufficient. It did not really cover Adam and Eve, and it certainly did not cover them from hiding from God. How can you use a fig tree or fig leaves to hide from God? There's no way. Nothing that we do or say, God is not aware of. God knew the leaves would dry up and become brittle. Eventually, they would disintegrate and blow away, and they would find themselves naked again. Thus, the substitute or what they tried to use to cover themselves, brothers and sisters, was inadequate. How much do we use substitute to try to impress or to please God? And yet the reality is, brothers and sisters, all that we try to do and to please God or to put on this front, it is inadequate. See, when Adam and Eve chose to use fig leaves to cover themselves, watch this now. Here we have the first lesson in salvation by works. They used things that they thought would get them right with God. Salvation by works. And some of us are like that. We believe if we dress a certain way, if we eat a certain kind of food, if we wear no jewelry, no makeup, if we are plain Jane or plain Bob, somehow that plainness will give us entrance and to the kingdom of God. But those things cannot bring about our salvation. We're not saved by our works. We're saved by faith through Jesus Christ. And yet, over and over again, people try to use their own self-righteousness or try to use mechanism or things that would kind of give them an edge up or head a lead based on how they viewed before God. And so Adam and Eve used these fig leaves, these mask wearing, they used them to try to cover themselves. Here's my sermon in a single sentence. Fig leaves and mask wearing cannot save us. Let me say that again. This is a short, simple sentence. Fig leaves and mask wearing cannot save us. Like Adam and Eve, we have donned our fig leaves to cover our exposure, and we think that it's going to cover us. And here's the question. How long are we going to keep living a fig leaf life, pretending like everything is okay? How often do we, in our own futile human effort, find a substitute for the garment of innocence? They chose fig leaves as a covering. And God knew that the fig leaf was inadequate. But more so, not only was it inadequate, but because they sinned and because they came short of the glory of God, you cannot use fig leaves to cover oneself. There is a difference between a fig leaf and animal skin. And what is that difference? It's the blood. And the Bible says in Hebrews 9:22, where there's no shedding of blood, there can be no remission of sin. See, the fig leaf could not do it because whenever you disobey God, whenever you are disobedient to God, when you look at verse 21 of Genesis chapter 3, notice what God said, unto Adam and to his wife, the Lord God made coats of skin and clothed them. That's a loving God. See, God knew that the fig leaves were not able, adequate, to rid them of their sin. In fact, by killing an animal, that was the beginning of the sacrifice, that it would be a type that when Jesus would come and be the sacrificial lamb to take away our sin from the world. But see, that's why I said the for sale sign of mass and fig leaves, because when you look at Calvary, Jesus has done it all for us. He has covered us with our unrighteousness. He has covered us. We don't need to put on fig leaves anymore. We don't need to put on masks anymore. All we got to do is come to Jesus just that we are, accept him, what he did for us on Calvary, and he covers us. Notice the text says, and he and he had to kill an animal. So every time Adam and Eve were to get dressed with clothing, they had to kill an animal, and that animal would represent something to them, that something has to die in order for them to live. They chose to use fig leaves. But I don't know about you. I'm not long with this message today. I don't know about you, but I'm so glad that the God I serve, he says to me, George Thornton, you don't have to wear fig leaf clothing anymore. If you accept me as the Savior, I can cover you. Your past, your present, anything that you've done, I can cover you if you accept me as your personal Savior. What Jesus is really saying, the songwriter says it best, what can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Take off the mask, the fig leaves. They don't fit anymore anyway. It's time to be real. See, Jesus is saying to you and to me today, and I hope somebody hears this, you don't have to wear fig leaves to impress anybody. You don't have to wear a mask to impress anybody. Because the song that I want you to hear is a song that says, he knows my name. He knows my name. He knows where we are. He knows what we've done. He knows where we've been. He knows what we're feeling, what we're going through. He knows our name. You don't have to cover up anymore. You don't have to feel shame or guilt anymore. He knows us. He loves us. That's why in Genesis chapter verse 21, he killed the animal to clothe them so that clothing would be sufficient until the fullness of time when Jesus would come. Oh, my brothers and sisters, I don't know about you, but I'm glad he knows my name. I don't have to fake the funk anymore. He knows where I've been. He knows what I'm feeling right now. He knows what you're feeling right now. Listen to this song. And as you listen to it, will you join me today and say, Lord, help me to shed myself of the fig leaves. Help me to take off the mask of pretense, the masquerade of trying to impress people. Help me to be honest and to be open and to be true to you. Oh, he knows. He knows. He knows our name. Can't you hear him calling you? Can't you hear him calling your name? He's saying, we are his own. I've got a wardrobe for you. I can cover you in my righteousness. And then when we get on the other side, he's going to put us on a robe of righteousness. You can put up the for sale sign and you can get rid of your mask. You can get rid of your fig leaves, because there's a God who loves us and accepts us just as we are. And that takes an awful lot of pressure off of me. I don't have to please you. You don't have to please me, but all I've got to do is please God. And when I come before him, Father, I stretch out my hand to thee. No other help I know. If thou would withdraw thyself from me, whither shall I go? He says, come unto me, all ye that labor and heavy laden, and I will in no way, no wise cast out. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just
not only forgive us, but watch this, to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Hallelujah. He knows our name. He knows our name. He knows my name.
Sing this before him. Say, you know my name.
He knows our name.
You know my name.
And I'm so glad he knows me. I'm so glad he loves me. I'm so glad that nothing that I can do, if I go to him and ask for forgiveness, he will give me his robe of righteousness. You can take down the for sale sign, and whenever they sell something, they always put the word S-O-L-D, sold. You let somebody know you're sold out for Jesus. And I am his own. Oh, thank you, Father. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Come on, worship with me right now. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Let me pray with you now. Let me pray with you now. Father God, so thankful that we don't have to wear fig leaves anymore. We don't have to wear a mask anymore. Spiritually, those things cannot cover us. Father, may this be a breakthrough for somebody today. Beloved, now we are the sons and daughters of God. It does not yet appear what we shall be. But we know when Christ shall appear, for we shall be like him, and for we shall see him just as he is. I'm so glad you know our name. I'm so glad you died and you became the propitiation for our sins. Thank you, Father. Bless somebody today. May somebody right now, wherever they may be in their home, right now, may they give their fig leaves to you. May they give their mask to you and say, Father, clothe me in your righteousness. Father, I ask that for myself and for my family. Bless us now, we pray. And we're so glad, we're so thankful, hey, that you know our name. That you know our name. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give it all to you. And the people of God say, amen. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, beloved, may God bless you until next time. Stay well. Stay safe. Stay home if you can. And keep in mind that he knows your name. You don't have to pretend with him. He knows. And we are his own. May God bless you.